Hello and welcome back to Yuga Gotoku 4. Last time, remember, we were still with Taiga. And now it is time for us to end his story and move on to part 3. So, without further ado, let's get into chapter 4 of Taiga's storyline. Oath of Brotherhood.
Hold up. Why? I had a feeling you were just another psychopath. The hell does that mean? If you had killed Ivan, I would have denied your request.
Excuse me.
People come here to see blood, but letting my prize fighters murder each other would be bad business. I'm relieved to see that there's some humanity left in you. Get to the point.
I'll tell you what you want to know. What society is.
That death match back in the Underground Coliseum. It was a test.
What's that supposed to mean?
I wanted to see how you'd act under those circumstances. Hope you don't hold it against me, but it was necessary.
Relax, Ivan will survive. Hell, he'll be back in the ring in a week at most.
But for now, he's in the hospital. That was quite a beating you gave him.
At least I know he's alright.
Now, as for that request about your patriarch's fate, following an incident 25 years ago. As the Sasai stepped down in 1985, the Ueno Seiwa clan put a hit on him, forcing him to go into hiding. Several months later, someone brought him down here to Purgatory, but he was barely clinging to life. He's been living on the streets since then.
What? You're telling me Sasai-san's still alive?
Yes. It was all we could do to keep him from dying. He's homeless now, but he's still in Kamurocho.
I see. That's it.
What?
He's probably, how should I say, not the man you remember. I have him brought over right now.
Here?
Yeah, that's right. Bring him in.
Floris does not fuck around.
Sasai down here, half dead, quarter century ago. It was Majima Goro.
What?
I can only assume Majima's trying to protect Sasai from the Ueno Seiwa clan after you were gone.
Sasai-san.
うれしい。うれしい。ささいうれしい。うれしい。ささいしまです。今帰ってきました。無駄だ。脳この男に自立した意識はない。いくら話しかけても反応することはない。 嬉しい。俺です。帰ってきたんです。親父。 し、なんで暗いなことに、なんで、なんでや。
Damn, man.
Had some time to take it all in.
Yeah, I owe you one.
Thanks for letting me see him again. Deal's a deal. So, what will you do now?
There's one more thing I gotta find out.
You mean Majima?
Yeah, like I know what really happened back in 85. I want to hear it straight from his mouth. Have I spent half my life behind bars for nothing? I can't go out without knowing.
That reminds me, you broke yourself out of prison, right? It would seem the police are hot on your trail. I heard they got wind of you being cited in Kamurocho,
so he's crawling with cops right now. Shit.
You better lay low until things calm down. You still have the hideout, don't you?
Yep.
Then wait it out there for a while. You should be safe from the police as long as you stay on the ground. You look big enough to handle a manhole cover. Use those to access the sewers and you'll be able to move freely. Right outside here, there's an entrance to the underground passage. It'll take you to one of Kamurocho's manholes. I suggest using those manholes whenever you find them. They'll help you get back to your hideout undetected.
Gotcha. Thanks.
Head to the hideout. Time to be a mole. This music. Far beyond the levels of being naturally chill. I like it. To Children's Park as soon as the everything calms down.
Stay out of the top sight till I make it to the hideout.
Hey! Wait, Seiji, my son!
I watched you fight. It was impressive how you withstood all that pain. I was moved!
Who the hell are you?
Oh, sorry. My name's Sodachi. I run a dojo in the neighborhood.
Tell you the truth, I was hoping you could help me with something.
Help you?
Yes, but let's talk to my dojo. That way you can see it for yourself. It's really close by. You have a little time to spare.
Sure.
Fine, but make it quick.
Great! Woohoo! Just follow me and we'll be there in jiffy.
Is a good change of clothes, you'd be alright.
Place ain't half bad.
I knew you'd think so. I put all my hard-earned savings into making it this way.
It's always been my dream to run my own dojo.
Impressive. But there ain't no one here.
That's the problem. The truth is that I only have one apprentice at the moment.
One? That ain't enough to wash the floor.
Exactly. It's a good location, though. And there were a good number of apprentices at first. But everybody quit within days.
Why am I thinking of a Rurouni Kenshin?
It's probably my fault because I'm no good.
No good?
Yeah, the truth is, I'm a terrible fighter. I've never won a single fight, and not even once.
Eh? So how the hell do you train your apprentices?
With my theory on fighting.
The fuck? Theory on fighting.
That's right. For years, I've been conducting thorough research on how to become a stronger fighter and defeat my opponents. Nobody can beat me when it comes to theory. I've come this far just by believing in my theory. As long as I follow it, I know I can train a great apprentice. Even if I myself am weak.
Sir, I want you to follow my finger.
But it turns out that no apprentice will trust a weak teacher. It's just a matter of time before this dojo is forced to close its doors for good. I've done my best to follow my dream of training a champion, but to no avail.
I see. I bet it's hard to have your dreams crushed after building such a fine dojo.
Yeah, and that's why I've asked you here today, Saijima-san. Would you work with me to help train my apprentices? Yes, after watching you fight at the Underground Coliseum, I knew you were the one I've been looking for.
In the nice dream delight.
You're not only a great fighter, but you also show compassion even to your opponents. I'm sure apprentices will look up to you. Of course, I'll support you the best I can. Please, please, Saijima-san, I can't give up now.
Sure.
See what I can do.
Thank you! You won't regret it! And now, Saijima-san, I formally welcome you to Sodachi Dojo!
Hey, Sensei!
Oh, Hide-chan! Perfect timing! Please, let me introduce to you.
Excuse me.
Let me introduce you to Hideo Sugiyama-kun. Hide-chan is my dojo's one and only apprentice. Hide-chan, this is Saijima-san. He'll be teaching here for a while. He's an amazing fighter. And when I say amazing, I mean all this world amazing.
Oh, that's great. Hideyoshi-kun. Sugiyama, Hideo this. But you can call me Hideo. I look forward to being your student.
Yoroshiku.
Now, how about we get to training right away? Our goal is to make Hide-chan the champion of the rookie tournament.
Rookie tournament? What the hell's that?
Oh, sorry. I didn't explain that yet, did I?
No, you didn't.
Excuse me. I am not trying to, you know, do anything as crazy as what I'm doing right now. I'm trying to roll off the top of my tongue.
The Coliseum holds regular tournaments that are only open to rookie fighters, with the purpose of finding the next star fighter.
I remember that movie. Oh, wait, it was the last star fighter.
Winning the tournament will earn you recognition as a full-fledged fighter and the opportunity to air other tournaments in the Coliseum.
Excuse me on this long day.
Underground Coliseum fighters are the true cream of the crop. Reminder, this is before Dragon Heat.
Since the rookie tournament is full of rookies who hope to become underground Coliseum fighters someday, the fights are always fierce.
I didn't have that when I fought.
I hear you were specially nominated. People with astounding strength and a good record are nominated and gain immediate entry. By the way, if you win the rookie tournament, both the fighter and dojo receive prize money. If I had that money, I'm sure that I'd be able to renovate this dojo up quite nicely.
I get it. Like killing two birds with one stone, right?
Exactly! Well, that's enough explaining. Let's get to work!
I'm looking forward to training with you, Saijima-sensei.
You'll be in charge of arranging the training menu. The menu has four regular slots and one special slot. These five slots equal one turn. I'll choose the special slot for now. You'll be in charge of selecting the regular slots. After you're done, press begin to begin training. I'm sure you'll get the hang of it once you get started. Okay, let's do it.
Oh god, it's live a live.
Train your princes and have them win the tournament within 50 turns. The sooner they win, the better the prize money and the evaluation. You can earn the most prize money by having your princes win within 15 turns. After that, the amount will start to decrease every 5 turns. Train your princes efficiently so that they are able to win in as few turns as possible. Fighter Maker. Alright.
According to Sodachi's plan, it's time for a meeting with you, but I ain't the meeting time. How about we do this over drinks?
Okay, I'd love to. Sounds great. You can talk over drinks to develop a relationship of trust. It's the fundamental principle of my theory of fighting.
Right, let's go, Hideo.
Of course.
Might as well just do fighter mate.
Huh, what about me?
What about you?
Huh? What do you want?
Nothing. Don't worry about me. Have a good time.
They forgot about me. Like, what about you?
Nice cold beer's the best, especially after a hard day of training.
Got that right. So tell me, why did you decide to start fighting?
The reason I started? Well, it's not a very noble reason, but... I did it to get a girl that I like to knows me.
Yeah, okay, you're doing it for nothing.
hell are you talking about? There's this girl named Mayako-chan that I've had a crush on for a while. She's really cute and sweet.
Why didn't you tell her this?
If possible, I'd like to make her my girlfriend.
But I'm not very special and I lack confidence. She's sure to say no, even if I could ask her.
How do you know? So you wanted to get stronger and gain confidence in yourself. Exactly. I wanted to become a man that's worthy to be by her side. I started fighting to gain the confidence to ask her out. It's an impure reason, right?
No, it's not impure. No, it ain't. It's actually a real good reason. Becoming a better person to achieve a goal is a respectable attitude.
Even if it's for a girl. Saichima-san, thank you. I actually felt really guilty about that for the longest time. I feel better now, though.
Well, it looks like he's a bit more motivated.
Welcome back. Did you have a good time? It's important to develop trust, so make sure to take your apprentice out for drinks again sometime. The greater the trust, the more your apprentice listens to you, meaning more efficient training. Try building a good relationship with Hidei-chan. Look, that's the only reason why you're doing this? Just to become a better person? I don't know, really. So yeah, even if you're doing it for a girl, the most important thing is you're doing it for you. You want to get the confidence. You want to be a better person. That's the most important thing you want.
That's it for today. I gotta tell you, teaching a lot harder than I expected. No worries. You'll get the hang of it in no time. Just keep doing what you're doing. Who's that sleeping over there? Another one of your apprentices?
Oh, and that's Fukushi Ochiai-kun. Doesn't pay a monthly fee, so he isn't an apprentice.
Seems that he just likes it here.
Comes by to take naps during the afternoon.
Oh gosh, it is live a live.
But don't worry about him, okay? He isn't a bad guy. He's definitely not a nice guy either. Just likes to sleep.
Fukushi Ochiai. Wonder what he wants.
Well, enough about that. Thank you very much for your time today. Come by to train apprentices whenever you want, just like you did today. We're always here at the dojo, so feel free to stop by anytime, please. Also, if there's anything you didn't understand, just read the Todachi notebook on the bench over there. It'll explain everything. Yeah, just in case, if you didn't know how to do this, Fighter Maker.
Todachi notebook, huh? Gotcha. I'll read it when I'm having trouble.
Alrighty then. See you next time.
I don't want to empty out my item box. Take this out. This.
The only thing that's worth using. sees me, he should come running. Better move carefully.
Good, my beloved pupil. I am going to impart some knowledge to you. Listen well and engrave it in your heart.
Hey!
I love cream soda.
Hey! Arigato gozaimasu!
That's the reason why you use rooftops.
Wait, aren't you? Hi, I'm Kamiyama. We met in Okinawa, remember? As he was escaping all the chaos during your prison break.
Wait, but now after you or anything?
I mean, compared to you, I'm small fry, so nobody's coming after me. Still, I thought I should be careful anyway, so I decided to stay here for the time being. Starting a business on the roof, over there. My business is utilizing my expertise to mod equipment.
I still got to get things ready, but I'll come by again soon. My little brother's in town, too. He specializes in weapons. Maybe you should stop by and see him, too.
Already did.
I think he's set up shop in the Fire Alley by West Park.
Good to know. Everything is connected in this city.
Thank you.
police. It's right here. The guy we ran into, that's Renta Kamiyama. And he was in Act 2. Everywhere.
Hey, think you can let me through?
That's me, Japanese.
Like, just looks like the inside's just a kitchen, so no reason for me to go force my way.
The only way I can do this is do the following.
Wait.
Ah, hell.
Hey, you feeling so too, man? I talk about the soul inside you. The more you use your soul, the better your skills. The closer you'll be to becoming a true soul brother.
Soul orbs.
Train your soul and turn into powerful skills. That's all you need to do to make yourself strong, brother.
Like I hadn't done that already.
That's all the Millennium Towers around here. We all see it. Come on. My feet are killing me. I swear they said we just had to go this way, but
we just lined up in a subway tunnel stand. Did we take a wrong turn or somewhere? Trace our steps to that place under the theater, figure out where we got off track. Commerce was hard enough to navigate without getting lost beneath it.
So, where exactly am I?
That's what I did. I pressed down on the analog. Turn my map off. That's the first time I actually noticed it. The hell, dude?
その最初の旦那、この男が勝手に入ってきて。
I see that.
誰よお前？マジマ組の南っちゅうのや。あんたが最初のさんか。
マジマ組や。何しに来たんや。
Down boy, didn't come here looking for a fight. Just when I came in to say hi, Grandpa and his lame ass friend jumped me, so I, you know.
What you want?
The boss asked for you, whereas you two were bros back in the day.
Majima wants to meet.
He says to stop by the office tomorrow night. Millennium Tower, you know, that eyesore scraping the sky like it's nobody's business.
Fine.
Knowing the boss, he probably got some fucked up shit waiting for you up on top floor. I'd come prepared if I was you.
Hey. What's up? Give him a message to Macho. He best have some damn good answers ready. Not he's getting his shit kicked in.
You think you go all medieval on the boss, mate? Nah, dick. He straight up kill you. See ya.
Let's grab some shit eye before I sell the score tomorrow night.
Nice showdown with old Majima. Kamurocho still swarming with cops, Saijima son. Can't risk moving above ground. You're meeting Minami at the Millennium Tower tonight. Maybe you should rest here until nightfall. In the meantime, I'll go scope out the best route to get you there in one piece.
Much obliged.
Just let me know when you want to rest up. I'll stay put until then. I have a message from Takodoro.
Alright, come in. This about work.
Suzuki-san, have you ever heard of the Dragon Palace?
You mean the Undersea Castle and the old-ass fairy tale? What of it?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all. Forget what I said, anything.
Now hold up, you screwing me.
Yeah.
Perish the thought. It has to do with your assignment. Just want to make sure. Speaking of which, you'll be working as a bouncer at a certain facility.
A kind.
My apologies. It's a touch illegal, so
Takodoro himself will give you the details once you get there. May I ask you to please proceed to the abandoned building on the hotel district side of Park Boulevard. You can't miss it. Takodoro will be waiting out front.
Gotcha. Park Boulevard to the hotel district side, yeah?
Yes. Head to the building behind the red light district info kiosk. Please, try not to get lost. Oh, and could I ask you to stay here, Tadashi-kun? This particular job site's no place for children. Aww.
Don't sweat it. Go down the floor and keep an eye on the place for me, will you?
Okay, I will. Be careful out there, big guy.
Alright, then, Suzuki-san. Good luck on your assignment.
I'm heading to Hotel District side of Park Boulevard.
If I wanted to. Well, the only reason why I came back is because I wanted to get some shit done.
Yeah, I think I'll kick back a little.
Sounds good. I go check out the best route for you to get to the Millennium Tower in the meantime. Sure you want to go, Saijima-san?
Yeah. Time to sell a score for all the shit my boss has been through since 85.
25 years long ass wait, man.
You're telling me, kid.
Only one problem. Streets are still swarming with cops. No way you'll make it to Millennium Tower, Bug Ground.
Then how do I get there?
Take the north side exit to go topside, then go underground from the back of the Millennium Tower and exit at Shichifuku parking lot. Next, head to the rooftop from Pink Alley and go a little south before returning to ground level. After that, head south from the ramen shop, go through the basement parking lot, past Central Sewer, and come out a manhole in front of the Millennium Tower.
Sounds pretty fucking complicated, but I think I got it.
You'll be fine as long as you can avoid the cops. Sorry, man. Wish I could do more to help.
You done more than enough. Thanks for everything, kiddo.
You bet.
Saijima-san! 最後に俺に一つ教えてください。冴島さんは後悔してないんですか？25年ですよね。いくら親父のためとはいえ、25年もの時間たった一人無所にいて、それで後悔はないんですか？
なんでそのようなこと聞くんや。
どうしても聞いてみたくて。
そうか。お前も今からなんやでかいことでもしてかそうと思ってんのか。それで迷うてんのやろ。後悔か。ないことはないな。人をこの手で殺したっちゅうことは後悔しとる。後悔しきれんくらいにな。せやけど親父のために無所に入ったとか、それが25年も続いたとか、そんなんは後悔してへん。
どうして冴島さんはそんなに強いんですか？
別に強ないよ。ただこの世界に入るときに兄弟と決めたんや。極道中生き方を貫こうてな。人からはヤクザ言われるかもしれへんけど、俺は極道っちゅう生き方をプライド持って選んだ。俺の極道は仁義のためにあるんや。
冴島さん、
25年前もし俺があの場から逃げ出しとったら、そんな仁義に反したことした自分が許せんようになって、今よりもっと後悔しているはずや。 極道の勝負っちゅうのは一度しかない。自分の人生かけてでも勝負する価値のある瞬間が来た時は腹くくって勝負せえ。後悔する生き方だけはするんやないで。はい、頑張るんやで。
So technically, this is just basically stealth.
game in the world that just says, in order for you to play it cool, to stealth it is simply walk. Keep forgetting. Oh, go here. Go here. Go up there. Go here. I can actually run my natural speed now. I couldn't do it above. I couldn't do it above ground. In this case, yeah, you have to. To make a corner. Oh, God. Sometimes when you gotta be focused, you gotta be really, really focused on paying attention to where you're supposed to go. Sewer. See, what can I get for this? Okay, good. They really want me to work hard for this, huh? A large blow-up doll. Freak out, it's a Millennium Tower. Finally made it.
Actually showed up, Saijima!
Damn street.
Word from the boss man, you say who you was? We're all getting our ass handed to us.
This is a test, though.
Yep, and I'm curious, what's our man my boss calls bro? Hope you don't mind if I let loose.
Fine by me. Gives me a chance to see what kind of Majima scraped together. Take your best shot.
What?
Hey, boys! This dude's one brother with the bus. But that don't mean he gotta win. Shit to kill! This shit's on!
Of course it is. Face Jeffrey McWild, which is... I'll take that. Everybody's gonna take one. You? 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 Thank you. That's one. Imagine him in a Hokuto game. Dude be OP as all get out. Like, on Nanto levels of ass whipping. Remember, Nanto, good lord, Nanto got some people that will fuck some shit up. Much picture him being a Nanto. Because he'd be too good to be Hokuto. Come here. He'd be on the level of Andre the Giant, if not King Kong Bundy. Congratulations, you nailed one hit off me. Whatever Majima taught you, he taught you pretty good. The hell is some trunk and fist bullshit? Two. There went another one.
What in the name of Mortal Kombat are you doing, sir? I got a charge meter like King of Fighters now. Nice! Breaker stands. Oh, hell.
Yeah, he's doing some drunken, fist bullshit. Some bull, sir. Damn thing in my face is flying. Getting stupid now. Thank you.
Finally! Shit!
さすが兄弟や。部下に教育しとるみたいやな。
待たせたな、兄弟。
真島。
お前にはいろいろ言い訳せなあかんねや。場所変えようか。ちょっとつらかせや。
Man, leading to a double boss battle. The fuck?
これなら警察も近寄れんやろ。さ、行こうか。
Majima got stats. That's all I'm gonna say. He got stats.
どこに行く気ない？
俺とお前の遊び場や。
あそこは。
Yo, batting grounds. Yoshida batting center.
行くで。俺らの思い出の場所にな。
久しぶりに歌えんか。マジマ。俺がなんでこの町に戻ってきたんかは分かったんだよな。
些細のおじきに会うため、それに俺への復讐ってとこやろ。
それが分かったんやったら、なんでこんなことしてんねん。俺は25年前の裏が知りたいんじゃ。なんでお前があの日来へんかったんかを知りたいんじゃ。
してんねん。早くこっち来いよ。忘れたんか、俺らの約束。一度この世界に足を踏み入れた以上、義理は貫き通す。絶対に口は割らぬ。それをもし裏切ることがあったら、その時はたとえ兄弟であっても殺す。俺らが兄弟の杯交わした時約束や。
忘れるわけあらへん。今でも一言一句覚えとる。どんな理由があろうと俺はお前を裏切った。些細な親父を助け出せんか。マジマ。
何や。
何や兄弟。昔みたいに殴り合って決着つけて、俺に言い訳させてくれ。お前が俺に勝てたらの話やけどな。舐められたもんやな。
トラ。
安心したわ。まだ体はダブついてないよ。25年間無所で毎日鍛えられとったわ。ノーノーと暮らしとったお前とは違う。それじゃこっちも手加減なしで行かせてもらうぜ。望むところへ行くで。兄弟。
We're taking him on, the mad dog himself.
looks like it's a damage race now. Wow. My emails are coming in like crazy. Okay. Give me some work. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, hell no. Not when I'm that close. Done!
ギラギラしてた。いつの間にか俺もお前も
親父になってしまった。お前の関西弁も板についとるやないか。あ？なんや、バカにしとんのか。いや、ちゃう。ただな、昔のお前は俺にとってもっともっと強かったような気がするんや。 大体その眼帯がないや。そんなもんしとるから。これは関係ないわ。もうこの目とも25年の付き合いやからな。25年？せや。俺や些細のおじきがお前を失ったあの日、俺はこの左目も失った。何やと。 頃よりも実際弱くなってしもたのかもしれへんけどな。ま、元が強かったからちょうどええわ。兄弟、あ、その左目、あの事件に関係しとるんか。お前があの日こんかったんは、その目に関係してんのか。 教えてくれよ、兄弟。あの日、あの時、なんでお前は来られへんかったんや。あの上野清和会の襲撃計画、あれは多分 仕組まれたことやってんや。せや、せやけど確かめようにも確かめられへんねん。なんで？俺らをはめたかもしれんやつはついさっき殺されたらしい。誰なんや、そいつは。柴田や。柴田和夫。 おそらくやつが些細のおじきやお前、それに俺をはめた張本人や。That's
the end of part two. So with that, yeah, I'm actually going to make a new save. Yeah. April 21st, 1985, in an abandoned warehouse.
こんなとこ呼び出して、何のつもりなんですか。 しばらく会わないうちに関西弁うまくなりましたね。よく努力されてるようだ。島野さんが目をかけているのもよくわかります。せやから何なんすか。用があるなら早言うてください。柴田礼服ですか。今日は誰かの葬式ですか。いや、それは別に。 ああ、そういえば笹井のとこの冴島も今日は礼服を着て出かけていったみたいです。そうですか。担当直入に言います。今日の上野義晴の襲撃、真島さん行かないでください。<笑>どうしてそれを。 あなたと冴島が今日出所直後の上野義晴を都内のラーメン屋で襲う、そういう計画ですよね。 実はあの計画ちょっと問題がありましてね、予定を変更させてもらうことになりました。
どういうことや。
上野清和会を今潰すのは得策ではない。堂島組長がそう判断したということです。
何やと。
そう興奮しないで。これはあなたが所属する堂島組が決定したことなんですから。
柴田はん、ちゃんと説明してくれよ。
そもそも今回の上野義原襲撃の計画、あれは堂島組が都内の島拡大のため計画したのがことの発端です。その計画を堂島組は笹井組へと託した。そこまで知ってますね。
なあ、せやから堂島組の俺と笹井組の西島がやることになったんや。
そうです。でもこの計画何かおかしいと思いませんか。
何がや。
我々東城会はどうして出所直後の上野義晴が都内のラーメン屋に来るという情報を知り得たのか。考えてもみてください。2年もの間刑務所に入っていた人間が出所直後ラーメンを食べるなんて陳腐な行動に出ると思いますか。上野清和会の総長ともなれば国が用意した方面祝いに向かうのが常識です。
それは
おかしいんですよ。この話は最初から裏の内通者によって仕組まれた可能性が高いんです。
内通者。
狭く人目につかない郊外のラーメン店を襲ってくださいと言わんばかりの場所にわざわざ出所直後の大物が行くと思いますか。
それじゃどうして上野は。
おそらくこの計画、裏で上野清和会の裏切り者と東城会の裏切り者とが手を組み仕組んだものなんです。
裏切り者やと。
ええ、上野が出所後そのラーメン屋にやってくるという情報を出した人間、それを仕入れた人間、それが上野清和会の裏切り者、東城会の裏切り者ということになります。
それは誰なんや。
東城会の裏切り者は分かっています。笹井秀樹、今襲撃に向かっている佐江島大河の親、笹井組の組長である笹井がこの情報を仕入れた張本人です。
笹井のおじっき。
笹井は上野清和会とつながっている。笹井は東城会に上野が現れる場所の情報を流し、わざと我々が襲撃するよう促した。
どうしてそんなことを。
戦争を起こす気なんですよ。
戦争。
笹井は東城会が上野清和会に手を出すきっかけを作り出すことで、逆に上野清和会が東城会相手に戦争を仕掛ける理由を作り出そうとしているんです。
そんなようなことして何の得になるん。
さあ、そこまでは分かりません。ただ上野清和会にとってはこれ以上ない戦争の大義名分が出来上がる。何せ先に手を出したのは東城会なんですからね。きっと笹井は上野清和会側の内通者と手を組み戦争の事態収拾に動く。そうなれば笹井は一躍東城会の幹部候補として名が売れる。そんなとこでしょう。真島さん、今日の襲撃、堂島組の人間であるあなたは言ってはいけない。このまま襲撃に向かえば堂島組長、いや島野さんにも迷惑をかけることになってしまいます。真島さん、私の話聞いてますか。
兄弟はもう向かってねえや。じゃあ俺はどうしたらええんじゃ。
真島さん、
あんたは俺に兄弟を裏切れっちゅうか。このまま見殺しにせっちゅうか。
落ち着いて、落ち着いて。
俺は行く。たとえどんな裏があっても構わへん。俺にとって佐江島はたった一人の兄弟なんじゃ。
真島さん、でもそれじゃああなたの身も。
うるせえ、関係ないわ。こっちはそないのもとっ
国捨てる腹って人じゃ。
そうですか。それじゃ仕方ありませんね。
おい。
And this is where
こういった手荒な真似はしたくなかったんですが、残念です。
柴田、
あなたにはしばらくの間ここで暮らしてもらいます。
柴田、さすが襲撃を犯されるわけだ。いいか、俺たちは親父の命令であんたをここに監禁してるわけだが、殺すなとしか言われてねえ。つまりだ、暴れたあんたを落ち着かせるためなら多少の傷を負わせても何にも問題ねえってわけだ。例えば目の玉の一つくらいだったらな。さあ謝れ、泣いて俺に詫びろ。 できへん。
何？
俺が頭下げれんのは自分の親父と自分が認めた男だけや。
それじゃ覚悟はできてるってことだな。
目ん玉一つくらいでお前には頭下げん。
ああそうかよ。
This starts up part 3. Masayoshi Tanimoto. For chapter 1, The Kamurocho Parasite. So, what I'm actually going to do is I'm actually going to stop here. And in the next part, we're going to do part 3, act 1. So stay tuned, more of Yuga Gotoku 4. Right after this.